of the dials. So before we go ahead and talk about machine controls and display of dials, let's see a small video which will give you an idea, even in an automated system where a worker is mostly using his fingers only, the lowest level he works on. Even there, we will be able to see that what kind of difficulties he or she might be facing. So I'm just sharing a video right now at the outset.
So could you please increase the volume of the video?
Excuse me.
Sir, mic is off.
Sorry, saying sorry.
Okay. So basically this video is about machine control and displays of the dials. So how workstation has to be designed. Can you mute? I think one of you have opened the mic. Yeah. So this video, we are not going to see the total video, but I just want to make a statement over here that a typical workstation looks like this, even an automated system. So because the things have changed, the times when this book was written, there was not so much of CNC usage, but now the things have changed. But still, you can see the work arrangement of the workplace over here. Some of the comments I'll give while the video is being played. So yeah, here we have to observe that how the worker movements will be traced, or you can see the movement of the worker on the shop floor. So he's got a tool over here, and now getting things. So you see the movement will be in this aisle. You can imagine a worker has to go somewhere here in the store and get this thing. I think it's kind of a tool which he'll be using in the machine. The movement was kind of an abrupt. So it's a short cycle work, especially like manipulation of controls. So you can see that when he'll be controlling the, when he will be using the display over there and the controls, using the controls, you can probably find awkward movement. I can say short steps and suddenly coming to rest, and then another short step and coming to rest. Actually, what happens is your body gains momentum as you start walking, and then suddenly when you come to rest, you will feel a kind of inertia is there, so you tend to get strained with that. I mean, over a period of time, tiredness will be more, even though you have not traveled much, but because of sudden movements, jerky movements, this kind of fatigue creeps in the worker. You can see that now. Just observe him we can observe him for another 1 or 2 minutes. say that the movement has not been much, but still, these kind of movements are awkward. Although people may say that the work has been simplified and now with the use of CNC, it is much easier. Easier, of course, because easier for the manufacturer because the quality dispose or the skill required by the worker is not that much in demand, except that you should know how to program the CNC and few things here and there, but the skill in making the work is not required. Okay, so that way, from manufacturer's point of view, it has eased, but worker still you can see a lot of jerk, movement is there, so physically he'll be drained. You can say controls. So the controls should be convenient. So you can see the panel is right located right where he's looking at the machine also. So controls are conveniently located over here. And arrangement of the dials. So here you can see there's not many dials over here except the screen. Everything's coming over here. But then there are many machines where you have to take readings from different dials like pressure gauges and all. So that also can cost a lot of fatigue. Further, ergonomics is another part which comes into play, which is the study of relationship between worker and the environment, particularly related to anatomical, physiological, and psychological knowledge. Right, so ergonomists they carry out many experiments to decide on matters such as best layout of machine. So is this the best way the tools have been arranged like this? Could there have been a different way, or could there have been an alternate better way of arranging these tools over here? At times he's walking is to come out and then go right around the corner. So could it be different or the best dimension for seats? So there's you can see over here there's one particular seat which is lying over here, but he will not be able to use it for a while. It's going on for a longer period, the video. So you can see it later also. I have given the link in the slide. So you can further few things are there. This is the inside view of the machine. I mean, that's not particularly useful for our purpose. No. Just a second. So the ergonomist they take care of it, the best dimension for seats and the work stops. This is another one where you can see this is not CNC, but sorry, ad is there.
To 25 millimeters, width from 600 millimeters to 2,500 millimeters, load weight above 25 tons, cutting precision to zero.
It's just giving you views from different angles. So I think we've learned few things over here that the workplace design over here should be such for a worker where the sudden movement should be less, the dials and the indicators should be conveniently located, and it will contribute in lesser fatigue of the worker. Next, we come to a two-handed process chart. So this two-handed process chart is a process chart in which activities of the worker hands or limbs are recorded in relationship to one another. So it is a specialized form of process chart because we will know that for how much time a particular hand is being engaged And is there a too much load on one hand or on the as compared to the other? The advantage of incorporating time scale in this is because we are incorporating time scale here. So we'll be again using the symbols which we have used earlier in the process charts. And then with those symbols, we will be able to make the two-hand process chart. So I'm sharing you a figure. I'm sharing a figure with you right now. So we can see that, So a very small example has been taken over here to elaborate the two-hand process chart. We can see that if, let's say, I have to do sharpening, pencil sharpening, okay? So I'm using the symbols over here, which we already know. Now, what is the meaning of the symbols? I'll just revise it because slight change is also there. The circular symbol over here for the operation which we have used earlier, used for activities of grasp, position, use, release, etc. of a tool, component or a material. And then you have transport symbol over here. It is used to represent the movement of hand or limb to and from the work. So here, even though you are standing, but your hand movement could be considered in transport over here. So this is some different kind of change that you can expect to and from. So your movement of hand or limb to and from the work, a tool or a material is represented by the transportation symbol. Then you have delay over here. It is used to denote time during which the hand or the limb being used is idle. Delay is, the work remains the same that like, if one hand is working, other hand is moving. So delay is there on one hand, but other hand is working. So that's why two-hand process chart, okay? Then you have hold, which is used for the term storage. We generally don't use the term storage with it in the two-hand process chart with the triangular one over here, right? this symbol over here. So instead, the symbol is really designated as hold. So this is D saying delay, but this one is saying as hold over here. We are not saying storage. And it is used to represent the activity of holding the work or tool or material. That is when the hand is actually busy, but is holding something. Okay, but not involved in any process. You can see here the pencil. Left hand and right hand. So from left hand, you're picking the pencil, and while other hand is just waiting while the pencil is being picked. Then you have hold symbol over here. This hold symbol is a triangle, sort of a triangle. And then we have pick the sharpener, then insert the pencil in sharpener, hold. There's a difference between delay and hold over here. Can you tell why? Why we are not saying any delay over here, but hold we are writing? Anyone? This triangle which you see over here?
So that hold is useful for production.
Okay. No. Why right hand? For right hand it is hold. Because if you're sharpening a pencil, you can imagine that you have insert the pencil in the sharpener. So one hand, left hand is actually doing something while you are actually holding this sharpener. So although it is not idle, but it is holding it. Getting it? So I hope you understand that because holding is something which is more important than waiting. Getting it? So I'm not. Why didn't we write wait over here? Why didn't I use the symbol D over here instead of the triangle? For the simple reason that
a useful activity, but holding the shutter is a useful activity.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Then we rotate the pencil, and then the operation is being done by the left hand, but right hand is holding the sharpener. Then check for sharpeners, the inspection, and I think the other symbols are easier. So what is the use of this? We can just summarize it in a form of a table that left hand there are two operations, but right hand there were no operations for the right hand. Similarly, we can also see that delay is happening over here while there is no delay with the left hand. So slightly unbalanced. Okay, so this is one observation which we can make. Can anyone tell that what other use of this chart we can make? Yeah.
So we can check for methods that we can reduce. कैसे हम लोग काम कम मेथड स्टेप्स में कर सकते हैं efficiently.
Yeah. We can also see that is there a balance in the load on the two hands or not? This is another thing that we can observe. Okay, so the chart form there's a chart form we have to make. Like this is a form of chart which we are talking about. So the spaces at the top for usual information. So this is the usual information about. I think all of you might have studied this cutting glass tubes. So I'm also going to ask few questions from that. Adequate space should be there for sketching of the layout, the workplace layout. You can sketch it over here. Then spaces for the movements of right and the left hands. So this is the left hand, this is the right hand. So we are writing the movements of that. So this kind of space. So this is a typical two-handed process chart. And space for summary of movements. This is summary of movements at the bottom, you can see. So these are this is the basic structure of a two hand process chart. And some points while we are compiling the chart, like study the operation cycle a few times before starting to record. So don't just jump into recording. You should first observe it for some time. The cycles, what is the cycle? Cycle basically is consisting of repetitive movements. A cycle, if there are 10 things which are happening, they're going to happen in every cycle. So that's what it means. Then you have then don't do charting of both the hands together, but one hand at a time. And do not record more than a few symbols at a time. And the action of picking up or grasping a fresh part at the beginning of a cycle of work where we can start recording. So when should I start considering the starting of the work? Generally when you are starting to pick up or grasp something. Start with the hand that handles the part first and or the hand that does most of the work. So that's from there we should. So these are some of the basic points we can consider. Also only record actions on the same level when they occur at the same moment. So same level means holds the tube and picks up file. Okay, now let's say what is the meaning over here. Why are they on the same level? Level means that holds the tube and holds the file. I have written that together. No, because picking up the file has to happen first. So that's what it means, level one. So if you look at it hierarchically, holding the tube and going to the jig and inserting the tube to the jig. So you can see that there has to be a sequential flow of the activities in this. Now this two-hand process chart, which you have already studied, can anyone tell what this process is about? What is this cutting glass tube operation about?
So maybe it's for the what size of glass tube we want. The extra part needs to be cutted out.
So cutting a large tube into smaller pieces.
Okay. So what did you read about this process? Okay, this is as it is, means there is a jig and a glass tube is inserted in the jig, and it's we cut it from here. Now there is a you can actually break it by hand also, but we are using file. Why? Anyone can tell?
So can you repeat?
Like, I have two options. I can just bend it and break it with the help of jig, or they are using file. You know what is meaning of file? All of you have done workshop, right?
So for smooth edges at the end.
Yeah.
So we want a measurable length.
So for good finish.
See, measurable length is ensured by the slot, size of the slot in the jig. Okay, but I can actually break it by hand also, but then it will leave one edge. It will expose edge of the glass tube, which is again not advisable. That's why we are filing it. We are cutting it by just a second. I advise you guys to have the case, read the case again, and I'll resume in 5 minutes. So I may ask a few questions here. That first question was that why is it necessary to hold the tube in the jig? Why this question I'm asking you is the whole idea, record, examine. I mean, even in earlier, we have seen the control charts, not the control charts, the process charts. There are
you
three.
Presenting?
No, I'm not presenting right now. I'll be looking at who's answering or who's interacting. So why do we make charts? What are the three main components of charting?
To observe the certain process, what are the processes being carried out while product is being made?
Standard three terms. I mean, you should have seen that earlier. Teen main cheez hoti hai, koi bhi hum charting kar rahe hai toh.
Record, examine and develop.
So record, examine and develop. So in recording, what we record was that the tube was pressed to stop at the end of the jig, then marked with the file, and then eased back for notching. Okay. So this is what we are recording. It was then taken out of the jig for breaking. Then the chart will tell us in great detail about the recording of the movement of the hands, and it is a short cycle work. So two hand process chart is especially useful when you have short cycles. Okay, and so we then critically examine the whole movement of the two hands, and we check the original method that we are doing. We question everything. So some of the questions we can think about is like, why is it necessary to hold the tube in the jig? Why this question came? Can anyone tell why this question, like why I'm examining it? Why this question came at all in my head? Or there are many other points as well, but why only this question came, that why is it necessary to hold the tube in the jig?
Because there is the hold process at that point, which is consuming time. So we can find better alternate to reduce that time.
Yeah, because holding, you can see the right hand is having four operations of holding. Okay, and the transportation is also high for the right hand. So that's why this question is coming, that holding the file. So why is it necessary to hold the tube in the jig at all? So that was the first question that came into our mind. Similarly, another question which you can raise while you are examining work is, why cannot the tube be notched while it is being rotated inside? Rotated instead of the right hand having to wait. I mean, right, you can see over here, you can see in the diagram. Okay, I have to share it. So you can see here in the chart over here that tube notching notches tube with file here. So when it is being rotated inside, that time only why can't we do the notching instead that right hand have to wait for it? See here, not just tube. Okay, while you can see right hand is actually waiting, holds the tube. Okay, this part notching moves the file to the tube and then notches tube. So can anyone tell why this thing was happening?
So ऐसे कोई स्पेसिफिक रीजन नहीं है, बट शायद जैसे जो वर्कर काम कर रहा है उसकी वो आदत बन चुकी है कि वो स्लाइटिंग निकाल करके फिर घूम मतलब रोटेट करके उसके बाद नॉच करता है।
या सो सो इफ यू कांट रियली फाइंड वन पर्टिकुलर रीजन फॉर अ सर्टेन एक्टिविटी प्रोबेबली इट शुड बी रिप्लेस्ड और eliminated with. Okay, so it's not like आपके यहाँ पे जो भी question मिलेंगे उसके लिए आपको एक plausible reason मिल जाएगा, but over a period of time things evolve in such a way कि आप कई काम क्योंकि आपके आपका जो superior है वो वैसे करता है तो आप भी वैसे ही करते चले जाते हो besides questioning why it is being done. Similarly, the third question which may come is that why does cube have to be taken out of the jig to break it? So I think I already talked about that earlier, because it will exposes a sharper edge, so which is not advised. If you're going to just break it, edge will be exposed, so that you'll have to file it. And why pick up and put down the file at the end of each cycle? Can it not be just held? Like you can see the first and the last operation, I mean first one and the last one, picking up the file and to the file again going.
Sir, tube break karne ke liye to dono haath chahiye honge na?
Yeah, so you have the answer for that. Now this thing was by with the help of such questions, raising the questions. few things were simplified in this. Now I want someone to explain how it was simplified. So we can have anyone would like to volunteer. Now how this is an improved method, of course we can see in the previous one that the number of moments are 14 and 14 over here, and after that the moment is 3 and 3. So many moments have been reduced, the operations have reduced by 2, and the there is no transportation. Just by having one jig you have been able to reduce by more than 100% the number of operation and the number of steps in it. So you can see how it has got simplified. Pushes to stop. Okay, this is a you insert the tube till it stops, and then holds the file. Now I want one of you to explain what has happened over here. How come we have reduced it by so much with simple use of a jig, where in this case there was no jig over here and a stop has been used. So one additional thing which has come up.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, in this improved method, is this jig which we have used is movable? Or it is fixed?
No, it has to be fixed only.
No, so what I mean to say is that the length in which we have to...
No, cut... it is adjustable. We can say it is adjustable, but it is stationary.
So, sir, that can be a reason for an improvement, because in previous case, the jig was fixed. So we had to import some kind of glass tube inside it and had a fixed length to have made it to a point where we can break it. But here we can adjust the length and it reduces the amount of time to adjust it.
Okay. Anyone else? Sorry, or
it also balances, so we don't want to hold it.
How?
Sir, in this method, it is not actually required to all time measure that the mark is we are filing at the exact mark, because the jig is placed in such a way and it is stationary, so that we can without paying much attention we can just file it. And also it is not required to bend the tube because the नीचे जो है वो खाली है, तो जैसे हम फाइल करके उसको हटाएंगे तो अपने आप जो बॉक्स होगा उसमें गिर जाएगी, तो उसमें बेंडिंग का ऑपरेशन भी चला गया. और इसके अंदर मतलब अपने को बार बार उसको क्या कहते हैं, मतलब देखना नहीं पड़ेगा कि अपन मार्किंग सही फाइल मतलब सही जगह पर फाइल कर रहे हैं या नहीं कर रहे, क्योंकि वो ऑलरेडी जिग वैसे प्लेस्ड है.
गुड. सो एनी डाउट्स एनीवन हैविंग? ओके, सो वी कैन गो अहेड.
सर यहाँ पर जिग जो था कांस्टेंट लेंथ का उसको चेंज कर दिया गया ना अब.
हाँ, एग्जैक्टली. अच्छा, उसको चेंज करके एक स्टॉप यूज किया गया है. इसको
सर ये वैसा ना कि पहले हम नट बोल्ट को जब टाइट करने के लिए
आपने वाइस तो देखी है, वाइस तो देखी है ना आपने वाइस?
हाँ सर, वो ना जिसमें नट बोल्ट. अच्छा,
बेंच वाइस देखिए ना, उसमें एक जॉ तो उसका स्टेशनरी रहता है और एक जॉ मूव करता है. तो ये जो जिग बनाया है इन्होंने, ये उस वाइस की तरह ही है. जो मूवेबल जॉ है उसमें जिग लगा हुआ है, और जो स्टेशनरी जॉ है उसको बनाया गया है स्टॉप.
यस सर.
ओके, एनी अदर डाउट्स? ओके, सो
सर, सिंस द जिग हियर इज नॉट ग्रैबिंग होल्ड ऑफ द रॉड वेरी फर्मली, सो द वर्कर नीड नॉट like pull out the rod before rotating it. Here you can easily rotate it while it is in the jig. There won't be much friction acting on the rod.
Yeah, so it has greatly simplified it. So with that actually signifies the use of the two-hand process chart. it just exposes the problems which are underlying, and which even for a shorter life, shorter cycles, we generally can't until unless we jump deep into the problem, we can't come up with these solutions. So in order to understand it deeply, we have to have these kind of two-hand process charts. Of course, in industry, the things are changing. The manual work is less. Even if the manual work is less, we are designing robots to do it. So someone has to do it anyway. So even if a robot is doing it, you can actually cut down a lot of non-productive time of robots as well with the help of these things. So it's not necessary only human limbs we are talking about. It can also be robots. Then we come to the last part of this chapter, which is micro motion study. Micro motion study is again used in a place where very short cycles are there and which are repeated many times over. And we generally develop, with the help of micro motion study, we develop best possible pattern of movement. Meanwhile, attendance you can give now. So it enables the operator to perform operation repeatedly with minimum effort and fatigue with the micro motion study. So in the micro motion study, we use PMTS, that is predetermined standards charts. But that's going to come in a later part of the course. Right now, the PMTS charts are not going to come. It is going to come in time study. So in micro motion analysis, we use the kind of Thurbligs. I'll just show you one slide. Yeah. So we use these kind of Thurbligs where these Thurbligs represent very, very small activities, very, very small activities. And these can be of micro seconds. Like these activities could be happening in a span of microseconds. So, that's why it's saying micro motion study, and we studied from left to right. Okay, first left hand, then right hand. That way we studied. And this operation which is explained over here is finish hand filling copper workpiece. Filing of a copper piece. So, searching and lifting the workpiece. So the Thurblick which is involved is SH and H. Now, just a second. Now, just by looking at the Thurblicks, at times we may not abbreviate them. At times we may abbreviate them. So you can use symbols also instead of the alphabets which have been shown over here, or you can use the alphabets as well. So it's up to the user whether they want to express the Thurblicks with the help of these symbols or with these alphabets, like SH and H. So SH stands for search, and H stands for hold. Okay. So SH is like hunting for an object is SH, and hold is retention after grasp, like you have grasped something and now you're retaining it in your hand is defined as hold. So I'm going to share a picture. I mean, it's not very clearly given in the book, the symbols and the alphabets associated and the definition of the symbols. So I'm going to share a picture in the group, which you can use to understand Thurblicks. The second one was, which is happening is, and the time is also given. The difference between micro motion analysis and the two hand process chart was that the time is also, we are writing time also. And can you tell what is the unit of the time over here? Anyone? 400 is written.
Microsecond.
Microsecond.
Yeah, it
Millisecond.
is microseconds. So we use generally stopwatches used for this purpose. Earlier, I mean, if now the thing is that we use video cameras, and in the video cameras we already have everything. Like I get a recording, so I can change the scale of my time, and then I can find out again and again. So it was much difficult earlier when the videotapes were there, and you have to have a camera set up specially, and then you have to have a stopwatch in your hand. But now the things have changed. You really don't need a stopwatch. You can just you can have the time scale in your video, and then you can clearly write it. Much easier to write these times as compared to earlier. So when it's supposed to be a very big deal earlier in the sense I'm talking about 80s, 90s, that doing the micro motion study required so much of investment and all, but not anymore. So like the opening the vice, so it's taking U. So what is U is use, and use signifies that manipulating or causing a tool to do its function is the meaning of the use. Then PP is given, so which is pre-positioning, which is like locating an article in predetermined position so that it is ready for use, like clamping the workpiece in a vise. So you are locating it. And then TL is indicating transport loaded, like moving an article from one place to another. And then all these other things are there. I. So I is inspect. So you can use these symbols, and after the class I'll send that in the group.
Sir,
Yeah.
so what's the difference between position and preposition?
Position and preposition. Okay. So position is like turning to line up, orient or change the position. Okay. So your pre-positioning is generally for locating a workpiece. Locating a workpiece means that you want to work on the workpiece. Let's say centering करनी है. So centering is pre-positioning. Okay? आप workpiece को लेथ में लगा के उसकी centering कर रहे हैं, तो वो pre-positioning है. And then positioning is turning to line up, orient or change position. Okay? So आप उसको I mean, preposition basically relates to an operation. Just before an operation, you are locating a workpiece at a position. Okay? And positioning is that you're keeping it at your key, inserting the workpiece in the jaw, and then you that small motion itself of inserting the workpiece in the jaw is an indicator of positioning it. So pre-positioning is much more requires much more precision as compared to positioning. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
So it's just before ready to use. Pre-positioning is the position of the job just before ready to use. Okay, while positioning could be one before that.
Okay,
Okay,
sir.
so yeah, this was about micro motion study. I mean, you have to read this chart and all. Then there are a few things about photography and all those things which probably are not that important anymore, because we have different photography and recording techniques available now anyway, so don't have to worry about that. So with this we finish the chapter. Now after this chapter, if you look at your book, we have a case study of an office space. Okay, so that is for your reading, and probably we can go ahead and complete the work study part. So you can see that the chapter number, the method study part can be completed now. Methods and the movements of the workplace we have seen. So the next is define, install and maintain. Okay, so maybe in the next class we can finish this up and start with the time study. I'll just discuss one thing, that while we are if you can open the book, method study, the method study in office is chapter number 11, so which is basically a case, and you can probably do it on your own only. It does not require much explanation. Then I'll go to the time study now. There are a few chapters in between which are very interesting actually, but then chapter number 12 till chapter number 17, they are very interesting chapters, but I believe that they should be done after time study, or you can say work measurement. So work measurement, that is part 4, we are going to start in the next week. And after that, whatever time is left with us for the lectures, in those lectures, I will be using these, doing these chapters 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17, because some of these chapters are again going to come in your production planning and control course. Okay, so that's it for today.